In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning, all.
Today we celebrate the memorial of St. John Vianney. He is known to be a patron saint of priests. So let us pray for our priests. That we be a holy priest and we serve the people of God, be a good example for those we serve. Let us begin celebration by acknowledging our sins and ask God to forgive us. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life, Lord have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we feed us your body blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. And bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, who gave the priest St. John Vianney, wonderful in his castle zeal, grant we pray that through his instructions and example, we may in charity win brothers and sisters for Christ, and attain with them eternal glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The following message came to Jeremiah from the Lord. For thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, write all the words I have spoken to you in a book. For thus says the Lord, incurable your wound, grievous your bruise. There is none to plead your cause, no remedy for your running sore, no healing for you. All your lovers have forgotten you, they do not seek you. I struck you as an enemy would strike, punished you cruelly. Why cry out over your wound? Your pain is without relief because of your great guilt, your numerous sins, I have done this to you. Thus says the Lord, see, I will restore the tents of Jacob. His dwellings I will pity. Cities shall be rebuilt upon hill, and palace restored as it was. From them will resound songs of praise, the laughter of happy men. I will make them not few, but many. They will not be tiny, for I will glorify them. His sons shall be as of old. His assembly before me shall stand firm. I will punish all his oppressors. His leader shall be one of his own, and his rulers shall come from his kin. When I summon him, he shall approach me. How else should one take the deadly risk of approaching me, says the Lord? You shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will build up Zion again and appear in all his glory.
The Lord will build up Zion again and appear in all his glory.
The nations shall revere your name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth your glory, when the Lord has rebuilt Zion and appeared in his glory. When he has regarded the prayer of the destitute and not despised their prayer.
The Lord will build up Zion again and appear in all his glory.
Let this be written for the generation to come, and let his future creatures praise the Lord. The Lord looked down from his holy height. From heaven he beheld the earth, to hear the groaning of the prisoners, to release those doomed to die.
The Lord will build up Zion again and appear in all his glory.
The children of your servants shall abide, and their prosperity shall continue in your presence. That the name of the Lord shall be declared on Zion, and his praise in Jerusalem, when the peoples gather together, and the kingdoms to serve the Lord.
The Lord who builds up Zion again, hear in all his glory.
Christ came to Jesus from Jerusalem and said, "Why do you disciples drink the tradition of the elders? They do not wash their hands while they eat a meal." He summoned the crowd and said to them, "Do you understand? It is not that what enters one's mouth that defiles the man, but what comes out of the mouth is what defiles one." Then his disciples approached and said to him, "Did you know that the Pharisees took offense when they heard you what you said?" He said, "Replied, every plant that my heavenly Father has not planted will be uprooted. Let them alone. They are blind and carriers of the blind. If a blind man leads a blind man, both will fall into a pit." The last word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Jesus Christ.
The Pharisees and the scribes asked Jesus, "Why do the disciples break the tradition of the elders? They do not wash their hands when they eat a meal." Jesus knew deep in their hearts that they like to use words to criticize, to judge others. And he taught them the lessons of being really clean. That is, don't just cleanse the hands, but also the mouth, the heart, and the soul. Some of us have a tendency to judge others, especially when they have different view than ours. Pope has to say, those who live judging their neighbor, speaking badly of them, are hypocrites because they don't have the strength, the courage to look at their own defects. Speaking badly of others is gossip. And there's no such thing as innocent gossip. When gossip becomes a bad habit, when we use it to manipulate others, it leaves a bad taste in our mouth. Some people get used to this bad taste. Unfortunately, it becomes normal for them. Pope Francis mentioned that the voice is for praising God, and when we use our voice to speak badly of our brothers or sisters, we use it to kill God, killing the image of God in our brothers or sisters. He also said, gossip is a weapon of the devil. It is an act of terrorism, of how we can kill others with our tongue. My dear friends, we should not judge others because we are not entitled to do so. Only God has that authority. Let us remember when we judge others, we do not define them, but we define ourselves. Yeah. Let us offer prayer to our Heavenly Father.
For the church and its leaders, may the Holy Spirit renew us each day to keep our eyes fixed on Him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected and appointed leaders, may God give them the eyes to see those in need and hearts to serve them first. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for all those who are sick. May the Lord bring them healing, comfort, and strength. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our faith community gathered here, may God make us witnesses to his transformative love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who will die this day, may the Lord bring them swiftly home to him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the intentions we hold in the silence and stillness of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Heavenly Father, we humbly offer these prayers to you, and we ask you to answer them according to your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, that of all creation, the goodness we have received, the bread we offer you, who the earth and walk the earth, and to become more the bread for life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, that our obligation to the goodness we have received, the wine we offer you, to put our word and walk of you, and to become our spirit.
Blessed be God forever. He was betrayed and entered willingly into passion. He took bread and even thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat them. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying,
of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may gather into one by the Holy Spirit. We end with your worship around the world, and bring glory to the kingdom of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, Mr. Roger Bishop, Timothy, and Thomas, and Paul, the Guru. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who are dying in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us, we pray. That for the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed at the first time, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have visited you throughout the ages, even in every prayer to the life, and may praise them glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, to the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's mind and all can be found to be there to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, who pray for every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, and have the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who come to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
not only
that you should enter into our world, but only say the words of our soul shall be
Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. And I praise you as if you were already there to unite yourself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Baruch Hashem.
Amen.
Baruch Hashem.
Amen.
Baruch Hashem. Baruch Hashem.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the heaven of the heavenly table of Almighty God, the full of increased strength for our knowledge, be all who celebrate this day of St. John the End, that we may preserve the integrity, the gift of faith, and walk in the path of salvation you place for us to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Master's ending, the Lord of peace.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray together, Saint Michael,
the Archangel,
defend us
in the
battle. Be our protection against the wickedness of sin and of the devil.
May God help you.